My name is Dave Gardner. I've worked at Thorlabs for 11 years now, and I am the head manufacturing engineer for fluoride fibers. We're beyond the state of the art of what anyone's been able to achieve so far. So what we're doing now is really making it better than it's ever been before, which is really exciting. In addition to being one of the only fluoride fiber manufacturers, we have a vertically integrated operation here. We start with raw materials, essentially powders, that we then melt down and cast into preforms. Then we draw those preforms into fiber on one of our two draw towers. We have in-house metrology and characterization. And then just one floor up is our fiber cabling assembly floor. So we can assemble the fluoride fibers into patch cables and other devices in-house, as well as supporting bare fiber sales. So fluoride fiber has many applications, and some that come to mind are mid-IR spectroscopy in general, but specifically chemical sensing, things like that. There are some astronomy applications, of course, medical lasers and medical fibers as a light delivery fiber, or really just anywhere where it needs to be. You need to deliver light through an optical fiber in these wavelength ranges. In addition to the mid-IR applications, the heavy glass matrix of fluoride fibers also opens up some applications for novel fiber lasers and amplifiers using rare earth doped fluoride fibers.
My name is Rob Pavcek, and I'm a senior material scientist here at Thorlabs. I think we've taken it to another level at Thorlabs here now. So, I mean, it's really good. We keep a variety of multimode fibers in stock for both zirconium and indium fluoride, and also single mode fibers. Two practical applications of the devices that we've partnered with our laser group on are the Prism Award winning SC4500, and then also the PDFA, which is a telecommunications amplifier. The PDFA is something that you can't do in silica. Those energy levels in the praseodymium are quenched by phonons in silica. Because of the heavier mass of the ions in fluoride, it doesn't happen. So, or it happens to a much less degree. The PDFA fiber that we make is, you know, state of the art.
Our fluoride fiber capabilities have experienced tremendous improvement in the time that's been here at Thorlabs in New Jersey. We've made major improvements to the fiber attenuation, significantly reducing the light lost along the length of fiber. We've also made major improvements to the fiber's mechanical strength, to the point where the fiber is easy to handle and robust enough for a variety of applications. We've improved our geometry control, so things like how well do we control the core size of the fiber, or how well centered is the core inside the fiber cladding or the fiber coating. We've improved those specifications, but also how consistent we are. And then perhaps most importantly, we are now set up to manufacture this fiber in volume. We can work with OEM customers, and we deliver multiple kilometers of fiber per year. We have a variety of fiber metrology capabilities in-house. We can test fiber attenuation at a variety of wavelengths, from the UV all the way out to the mid-IR. We have in-house capabilities to test fiber geometry with all the required gauge precision, you know, to guarantee our specs, including looking at fiber cores, and we have submicron resolution on our fiber geometry measurements. We have proof testing for our fibers, as well as tensile and bend testing, so the full suite of mechanical testing to make sure our fibers are uniformly strong throughout. We have high power screening capabilities for our certain fiber designs that are designed for high power, so we can blast them with a pretty high power laser at a few different wavelengths. And every spool of fiber that we produce, every spool of fluoride fiber goes through the characterization process, and all the specs are verified. So again, we feel really good about not only does our fiber perform really well, but we can make all the usual Thorlabs guarantees, and maybe even then some, on quality product.
It's novel. You know, fluoride is unique. I think we could really convince people that fluoride is for real.